if you look at the malaria situation, the big red flags that we have to fight with and overcome are these resistance developments. One side the insecticide, one side the drug resistance. With the drug side, it's very worrying what we see in the greater Mekong sub-region. Six countries had touched there. But it's also worrying to see that you find the gene that is responsible for lower sensitivity, this famous K13 propeller gene, is also present in Africa, but has not yet reported resistance. So the key issue is not just to, of course, have new drug development, but also have surveillance. Not that we, after 5 years, detect we have problems in Africa. We must immediately detect that to convince people that surveillance also for many other communicable diseases, for emerging and re-emerging diseases like Ebola, Lassa and so on, is the key to be prepared. If you take the drug development that was initiated by the Novartis Institute for Tropical Diseases in the consortium of all partners involved, I think this is an absolute essential part of the next steps. We know that if we cut short on the drug development and think we have it now and we just finished the job, then we will make a huge mistake. We will actually have the resurgence of malaria in many areas, and it will be then very difficult to cut this back. We are not yet in 2030, but the targets are not very unrealistic. But where we must be realistic is in the capacity to really implement this with all people involved. And this means the capacity to work within health and social systems that bring this success. If we are only focused on tools, here a new drug, there a new vaccine, then we'll never succeed. We must have the systems that carry this to the people in the most remotest areas, the most neglected people, that we reach them.